looking to speed up your website, but you just don't know how? Well, I have the solution for you. It's called CDN, Content Delivery Network. And what it's going to do is that it's going to load the files nearest to whoever wants to view your site. What does that mean? Well, let's just say that my website files are located in California because that's where the server is. And if someone wants to view your site from the United Kingdom, China, Mexico, Indonesia, or whatever place in the world, well, it has to load those files all the way from California. Now that might mean seconds or milliseconds, but in the world of internet, milliseconds count. So having a fast website is really important. That's where Bunny CDN comes in. And what it does is exactly that. It's going to serve the files to pop centers that are close to whoever wants to view the website. So that speeds up the website. Well, what does that mean? If you have a shared hosting that sucks or a VPN that's crappy, well, it's gonna speed it up because it's gonna load the files from the CDN and the server. So it's gonna use the combination and it's gonna load way faster. So what I'm gonna do in this video is that I'm gonna show you the main aspects of Bunny CDN and how easy it actually is to install on WordPress, which is a popular CMS. But if you want to install this on any type of site, that is possible. Let's go jump over to my desktop and show you Bunny CDN right now. All right, this is my Bunny CDN dashboard. And the first thing I want to show you is that this is actually costing me pennies a day. Now, when I first got started on this, I've added a couple of sites that I thought were the most important for me. And then I saw it was costing me practically nothing, so I started adding more sites, and I will be adding more to Bunny CDN. So let me show you. I added $60 to my account, and I've practically wasted 43 cents, 2 weeks. I've been running it for 2 weeks on a few sites, and it's costed me 43 cents. The usage for December, 17 cents, and it's been 6 days. This is my monthly usage from these sections, for example, Europe, North America, Asia, Oceania. And let me show you their pricing. So I did confirm it's costing me pennies to run this. And you're going to see if your files are served from Europe or North America, it's going to cost you 1 penny per gigabyte served. And it's gonna load from 74 pop centers, pops. It will depend where you're loading from. If it's from Asia or Oceania, it's 3 cents per gigabyte. South America, 0.45 cents. And Middle East, 0.60 cents. So 6 cents per gigabyte. That's pretty cheap, right? So if there's also another volume pricing, it's gonna depend what you want to use it for, but this is the fast one. If you're going to serve videos or things like that, well, this is even cheaper to use that. So how easy is it to actually get started? Let me go into the overview right here, and I am going to add a pool zone. That means that's where I'm going to add my website. Let's go ahead and add a website, and we'll just add something random just for testing purposes. There we go. That's what I'm gonna call it, and then HTTPS. Again, this is just made up, all right? And then I'm being asked, do I want to use the standard tier? Or the high volume tier. And it's gonna tell you what it's for right here. The fastest one is the standard tier, but if you need high volume, that would be the way to go. And then comes the questions for the pull zones. Remember we saw different type of pricing depending where you want to pull files. Well, let's just say that I have a website that's on North America and South America. Well, I wouldn't care if it loads slow in these sections. So this is gonna be cheaper for me. And if someone pulls it from over here, it's just gonna load from these places, from North America and Europe. But if your site is worldwide and you do care about speed, well, you enable all of these. Let's go ahead and add this pull zone. Oh, pull zone already taken, why? Let me add that there, let's add the pull zone. There we go, okay. I already did a test with that name. So this is telling me how I am going to implement this on my website. Is it a custom HTML site? Well, I have to add this. If it's WordPress, this is the settings that I need. Their genre, Drupal, and open knowledge base. Let's go to a WordPress site just to show you how easy this is. And we just go ahead and go into plugins, add new, and go search for it. And let's go search for Bunny. And there's Bunny.net. This is the one that we're going to add. It's gonna add a plugin and we add the CDN link to it, which is this one over here. Where is that? There we go. This one right here, the pull zone, right? And if you don't want to install this plugin and you already have a cache plugin, that's gonna work for you. That's what I'm actually using. If you go into WP Rocket, that's what I'm using, but if you're using Lightspeed or anything like that, you'll go into CDN, enable it, and add that same link to it. That means you reduce the plugin installations and you're using your cache plugin. It's super easy to get started. Now, you're gonna be asking yourself, does it really speed up? Well, I did some tests on GT Metrics, and you're going to see that it speeds up my sites. I'm getting grade 8 in this. And yes, you do have to do a combination of settings for your cache plugin, files that are decently sized, and the CDN, which is going to serve them quickly, okay? So once you have it installed, let's go into one of the pull zones that I already set up. So let's go into this one. I already added my custom domain, so when it loads the files or someone views them, it's gonna say cdn.keepler.mx instead of this one that Bunny provides. And these are the settings. We have the pricing again. Just in case you disabled some of these and you want to enable it again, well, you can do so if you want. In this case, this is a site that I only am interested in Mexico, so that's why I only have enabled South America for this site. Again, if you want to switch to high volume tier, you can do so. SafeHop, enable SafeHop is a good feature if you want to serve the site in case it's down. Now there's several settings around this. So for example, origin retry reasons. So for example, connection timed out, you got a 500 response or any of the 500 variants, response timeout, the origin content timeout, and those settings. Cache-in plugin, so you can enable these and disable depending what you need. The perma cache, this is really cool because what it's going to do is it's gonna serve the files from their storage. So in this case, I can enable storage. And what that means is that instead of loading some of the files through the CDN, it's also gonna load from their storage. So it's gonna speed up the site even more and it's gonna use storage. Now, heads up, storage does have a price for it, which is pretty cheap also. Let me see if I can open this really quickly. Price for edge storage. Yeah, I think it's also this one. It's 1 penny per gigabyte. Let me see the pricing details really quickly. There we go. So there's different type of storages, and I'll show you that in a bit. It's 1 cent, 2 cents, and you can see that right there. This is per gigabyte per month. That doesn't mean it's not gonna matter the bandwidth or anything like that, or if a lot of people visit it, that's what it's going to cost you just to store it there. So it's gonna tell you right here, if I want to store it in all these places, it's gonna cost me 11 cents a month. That means that if my site is less than 1 gigabyte, that's gonna cost me a month, which is pretty cheap, right? So I already have this enabled, but not for this site because I don't need it to load from somewhere else. But if I go to storage, let me show you an add storage just to show you the settings. I can name it whatever I want. Okay, I'll delete that in a bit. And I can say the main storage region. So in this case, I can choose any of these. Europe would be the cheapest one per gigabyte per month. So I can choose any of these, and I can also enable all of these. What does that mean? It's gonna also store my files in those regions, okay? And it can pull from there. I can create different type of storage settings depending on what to use it for and connect my sites to it. What does that mean? Let's just say I create one, I'm only interested in United States. Well, I can create a storage for this and connect my sites to this that I care about to only load on the United States. But I can create a secondary storage that has all of these enabled just in case I have a site that I need to load quickly from all the world, okay? So let's go back into the pull zone. Let me go into SaaSmaster Link, for example. No, I didn't enable that one. This one. Okay, there we go. I have that enabled. Cache plugin, perma cache. You can see there, I have it tied to this one I created from the storage. And it's been serving, it's stored 9,296 of my files. So it's loading from there and not from my server, which makes it faster. And it's loading from these regions. Now you can see right here, I have turned off Australia because I didn't think that would be really important for me, but it will depend what you want to use it for. Okay, let's go into security. A lot of security settings right here that you want to block IPs, block post requests, and a lot of things. Login, enable log forwarding, etc. You'll have to check those out for yourself and see what you want to enable or not. What do you want to serve for 504 error? Well, you want to white label the error page enable status widgets, show custom error page, the S3 authentication, token authentication, the traffic manager, the headers, the bunny optimizer. This one is not included in this pricing, but this will cost you $9.50 a month per site if you want to serve the images with the compressor, load the WebP image compression, and all of this. I'm using other systems, so I'm not using that from Bunny CDN. You have edge rules and network limits. We can also view the statistics for this specific site, and this is what's been going on. The bandwidth used, 2.29 gigabytes, request served, and cache hit rate. The bandwidth served, request served, origin response time. You see how it's been loading faster. Now, this is really important. When you first add this to your site, you'll have to do several tests so these files get stored in different pop centers, and then it's gonna load from those pops, okay? The origin traffic, data center traffic, you got all this information of where people have visited from this site. So you got all that information to decide what you want to do, enable or disable things on Bunny CDN. You got purge, logs, and monitoring. Monitoring will show you how they've been viewing your site. In this case, if something's going on right now, we're able to view it live. But in this case, nothing is going on for now. But basically, it's super easy to get started. It costs you pennies, and it's well worth it, especially if you don't have a good server. Like I said, if you're using a shared hosting or a not really good VPN, this surely will help out to reduce the load on those servers, plus serve the site faster by serving the files nearest to whoever wants to view your site. That's the whole point about CDN. And it does work, and it's well worth it, especially if you care about people who want to view your site, view it faster. Well, there you go. That is Bunny CDN. I will be adding a link in the description. It's an affiliate link in case you guys want to use it. And there you go. My name's George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.